And now moving to the next portion of this template, which is to get the amortization schedule, we'll include all the necessary and important fields in the schedule table. So to start with, the first thing which we need is installment number that we will have in B13. So we type installment number here, and then in C13 we type installment date, then in D13 opening liability amount and installment amount in E13. In F13 we type principal and interest in G13, and last but not the least, outstanding principal in H13. So right now these headings are not readable since the text is lengthy and it is not coming in this column width. So we select this row and we wrap it, and now we select this range and we make it a center line, middle line and bold as well. The complete amortization schedule is going to be dynamic and fully automated. So to start with, we first have to make the installment number dynamic, and in order to get that, we skip the 14th row and we jump on to B15 and we enter if function here, and we open another parenthesis and enter row function and to get the current row number, and then we subtract the row number 14th row, convert it into absolute reference, and now we close the parenthesis, and now we tell it to check whether this criteria is greater than H7, and if the criteria meets, then print nothing, otherwise return the current row number minus previous row numbers and hit enter. Function return 1 as the output in cell B15, and when we copy down the same formula in 16th row, the function returned 2 as the installment number. Now we move on to the C15, where we will get the installment date. Since the EMI is starting from September 10, 2015, so the first installment is due on the same date. So here we enter if function and we check whether B15, which is installment number, is greater than the total installment. If the condition meets the criteria, then return empty text, otherwise return the date as per the specified number of months as per the EMI start date. So we select E10 here as the start date argument, and we freeze the cell reference, and then we take B15 and subtract 1 from it to return the date and hit enter. Let's format this, apply a date format. So we have got the first installment due date, which is 10th September 2015, and when we copy down this to the next row, we get 10th October 2015 is the second installment due date, which is absolutely correct. Alright, now we jump onto the installment amount in E15, as we'll skip the opening liability amount for now and we'll calculate it after some time. To calculate the installment amount, we'll use the payment function along with if function after checking the supplied criteria. So we start with if condition and check whether B15 is known blank. If it contains any value in it, then perform PMT function, and first we calculate the monthly interest. Let me freeze this here, and after that we have to select the NPER, and NPER here is total installment, which is given in H7 for now. And now we have to take the loan amount as present value. So we take loan amount here and we supply it as negative value, and then we close the parenthesis. Now we are back in the if function and have to supply the output which we want in case the logical test does not meet the supplied criteria. So here we enter empty text and close the function and hit enter. We get the installment amount in E15, which is exactly the same as we got it in H6. And when we copy down this to E16, we get the same amount because the scheduled payment will remain same until loan is active. Now to calculate the principal amount, there is a PPMT function, which is built-in function in Excel. So first we enter the same criteria here, and then we enter PPMT function. So first we have to calculate the monthly rate. So we select E7 and we freeze it and divide it by number of payment per year. And in the second argument, we have to supply the specific period for which we are going to calculate the principal amount. So here we take P15 and we'll keep it as relative reference, as this will be changing for each row when we'll be moving our function down in this column. After that, we select number of total installments that is given in H7 and we convert it into absolute reference. And then after that, we supply original loan amount and we supply it in negative value, and we close the PPMT function, and in false value we type to return empty text and hit enter. We get principal portion only of the first payment in the cell, and when we copy down this function, the principal amount has been increased for the second installment. Similarly, to calculate the interest portion of the payment, there is IPMT built-in function of Excel. Everything here remains same except the function name. So we go back to F15 and we copy this function and come back to G15 and we paste this function here, and we just change the name of the function from PPMT to IPMT, and the rest everything will remain same. And as soon as we hit enter, we get only the interest part of the payment for a specific period. And when we copy this down, the interest portion is getting reduced every month. That's because in standard amortization, initially the scheduled payments or installments major portion goes towards interest and a small amount for the principal. As the mortgage matures, the principal part gets increased and the interest part gets decreased. So now we have to calculate the outstanding principal, and we enter if function here in H15 and tell function to check whether D15 is non-blank. If true, then D15 minus F15, otherwise return empty text. We'll keep the ranges relative. As soon as we hit enter, we get nothing in the cell, and even when we drag the formula down to the next row, we still get nothing, because currently D15 and D16, which is supposed to have opening liability amount, is blank. So before we jump on to D15 and to get the outstanding principal as well, we come back to H14 and we refer here the original loan amount, which will initially be the outstanding principal before starting the loan. Now we come back in D15 and we enter if function and ask it to check the same criteria whether B15 is non-blank. If yes, then refer to H14, otherwise return empty text. And the moment we hit enter, we not only get the opening liability amount for the specific period, but also got the closing outstanding principal for this payment. And when we drag this formula down in the next row, we get the opening liability amount as well as the closing balance respectively in D16 and H16 for their respective period. So we have successfully created the amortization schedule, and now let's copy all the formula from D16 to H16 till 255 rows, as this will have maximum of 240 installments. Oops, so we forward to freeze the range here. This looks okay. So let's copy this here. I guess it looks fine. Yes. If you want more rows to be included to increase the payment numbers, you can drag these formulas down and can extend the range as per the requirement. And now, just to give the final touch up to this template and to make it look much better, we go to 12th row and we highlight 12th row till H12 from B12, and then we go to borders tab and more borders, and here we select thick border and we apply the top border here, and then we click OK. Then we reduce the row height from 15 to 3. Now we select B13 to H13 and we open format cells dialog box, and this time we select the lightweight line and we apply only top border and bottom border, and then we jump onto fill tab, and here we apply light background color gray as the background color, and then we click on OK. And now we extend the selections once again till the last row, and we apply center formatting once again, and then we again come back to 13th row, and now this time we select B14 and once again we highlight the 14th row till H14, and we go to borders and we apply thick bottom border, and this time we reduce the height to 4 and click on OK. And the final step, include your company or lender logo on top of the template. So for now, we insert some shapes here. So where is the shape? Okay, here it is. So we'll insert some shapes here so that it will give you rough idea that you have to include the company or lender logo. So we keep no color in this and we keep the outline as black color, and then we type here. Oops, I forgot to take the blank font color. And now I continue with the typing lender logo, and then I select the entire box and apply center alignment and middle alignment, and then make this text as bold and increase the size to 14. After that, we once again go to D15 and we select the range till D15 to H254, and we select as number format and we use 1000 separator, and we already applied the center alignment and now it looks much better. So we are now ready with the good looking amortization schedule template, and to see how it looks when we supply inputs in column E, so we enter some random numbers. Let's keep loan tenure as 1 and payment per year as 6, and there you go. The schedule automatically gets updated and gives you the breakup of each payment and tell you when the payment is due and how much payment you have to make and what would be the principal and the interest going towards in that payment. So whether you are planning for your next personal loan, home loan, car loan, or you are a small private lender, this template is good for you and can save your important time as well. You can download this template by just clicking on the link given in the description and can use it for personal use only. And in case you want to customize to have anything else in this template, you are allowed to make the changes, but only for the personal use, not for commercial use. That's all I have in this video. I hope you liked it and found it useful. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.